All right, you know we got to get on these rappers, and it's gonna be through the spirit and power of Yahweh, Bashem Yahweh Shah, Bashem Kakadas, Brakatai Yahweh, Brakatai Yahweh Shah. Now, first of all, these people are set up by the so-called devil, and we ain't talking about no fallen angel, no disobedient angel. We gonna get that off the top. Now, ain't no disobedient angel dealing with this situation. That's a lie from the real deceiver, Diablos, devil, the so-called white man. See, they created that lie before these Negroes even knew what was going on. For these people that's alive today and that can hear and see what's going on in the world, they had that lie already in rotation. When you go to Proverbs 11 and 7, not 11, 17 and 11, Proverbs 17 and 11, it's saying, evil man seeketh only rebellion. Therefore, a cruel messenger shall be sent against him. See, the Most High sent cruel messengers against wicked, rebellious people. And not only is he sending his angels to send a message to these people that want to rebel against what he got going on, against his word and his prophets. When you go to Sirach 39:28, it says, there be spirits that are created for vengeance. See, the Most High created spirits to punish these wicked individuals that want to rebel against him. And these spirits is not rebelling against God. They're obedient spirits. They're obedient spirits that he created to obey him and do what he say and punish the wicked and the evil men and the rebellious children. When you go to Proverbs chapter 4, in 14, it says, enter not into the path of the wicked, and go not in the way of evil men. 15, avoid it, pass not by it, turn from it, and pass away. See, that's not what these people is promoting with this rap music. You see, that's promoting death and destruction and rebellion against the Most High. That's not what these people are promoting. And so even these rappers are spirits created for vengeance. Because if you follow down the path of these idiots, you gonna end up destroying yourself. Okay, now when you go to Isaiah chapter 3, let's see here, Isaiah chapter 3 verse 12, let's get that. No, you know what, let's get 3 and, let's see here, Salaki, bear with me 1 second. Isaiah 3, I want either 16 or 19. You know, I'm thinking of chapter 6, gotta be. Well, let me start with chapter 3, and I'll find that chapter 6 later. But chapter 3, verse 12, it say, "As for my people, children are their oppressors, and women rule over them. O my people, they which lead thee cause thee to error and destroy the ways of thy path." See, they push this rap music into the black, so-called black community, and the so-called Hispanic community, because this was going to destroy the path. And so the women is ruling over the children in our community. They ruling over these fatherless children, and they push this rap music on them and destroy these children. That's why I say the children are their oppressors, because once you ain't got that man in that house to put some foundation on that child, and you ain't got that man to discipline that child, that child gonna be an oppressor. He gonna oppress the whole house. He gonna oppress the whole family, because he gonna be a child left to himself to destroy himself. And so that's what's going on with the so-called black and Hispanics, the children of the black and Hispanics, because they listening to these funky rappers. Now, verse I was trying to find is in Isaiah chapter 9, verse 16. It say, "For the leaders of this people cause them to error, and they that are led of them are destroyed." See, that's how our people is destroyed, because these funky rappers pushing this used drugs, live a dysfunctional life, and follow the so-called white man by chasing this fiat currency that ain't worth a dime, because gold and silver is the only money on the earth, the only tangible resource or material that's going to hold its value no matter what's going on in the world. But these idiots are following the so-called white man over some paper that he done created some old monopoly money, and ruin their life and destroy their life following the devil. And so you got these volunteers in our nation that'll run after the so-called white man and try to mislead the other people to go with them. Look at Jeremiah chapter 5. Jeremiah chapter 5. Let's see here. It speaks on these wicked Negroes that want to be rebellious. Okay. Let's see. Chapter 5, let's see here, is it 14, 15, now I might have picked the wrong one. But I'm going to come back to that one. Salakia. But it talks about these men of our nation that jump out there and set a trap for our peoples. Let me find this verse, man. Alright, here we go. 5 and 26. Now it say, "For among my people are found wicked men. They lay wait as he that set snares. They set a trap. They catch men." Not only do they catch men They catch a whole household. And look at 27. It says, as a cage is full of birds, so are their houses full of deceit. Therefore, they are become great and waxing rich. And they do it for money. See, not only is the so-called pork chop eating pastors is leading our people for money. It's these rappers. They are false prophets. They are preachers. They just a form of Christianity that's you know, on the TV and that's popular. See, all they did was push Christianity in a whole nother way. And see, I should have changed my whole video to rap music is extreme Christianity. Because hold on. Let me get 56. Because all it is, all Christianity is the so-called blacks and Hispanics, the men of this nation, pushing that crap on our people. See, because the men are supposed to be the leaders of the nation. So it don't matter what they talking about. If they not giving you the right path, you going on the path of the wicked. That's why I say the wicked men of this people. And they not only holding Bibles, they don't have to hold no Bible. Just like when you going to a raggedy stinking church, they not holding no Bible. Them niggas in there singing and dancing. And just like they on the rap video, just like they on BET or MTV or VH1 or on YouTube, singing and dancing, promoting money, pushing money, and living a prosperous life with the so-called white man in his kingdom. Now look at verse 10. It says his watchmen are blind. See, the men of the nation supposed to be the protection. They supposed to be protecting the people, watching out for danger. But that ain't what these so-called rappers is doing, these false prophets. They are all ignorant. See, they ignorant. They don't even know what the heck going on around here. They chasing money so bad, they don't even know that they digging their own grave. They are all dumb dogs. They cannot bark, sleeping, lying down, loving the slumber. This is the main verse, verse 11. Yeah, they are greedy dogs, which can never get enough. See, them niggas 40, 50 years old on a freaking verses, pushing that crap they was pushing in 1998, 99, 20-something years ago, these niggas pushing the same mess on the next generation, the children of our people, talking about we doing this for the culture, for the children. You see? They ignorant. You don't even know you setting the children up. You setting the legacy of destruction for our peoples, for the children. You setting them up for destruction by pushing that ignorant mess on them. But they can never get enough of this money. They don't want to listen to the prophets and say, oh, man, we were doing that dumb rap crap. We need to get right, man. We the greatest peoples of all time. See, they are shepherds that cannot understand. They cannot understand that they came over here on slave ships with chains on their behind, just like a nigga go to jail because he found dope in the back trunk, in the back of his trunk, and the police put some chains on his behind and throw him in prison for being rebellious and hard-headed to the law. See, that's exactly what happened to these Negroes. Shepherds that cannot understand, because they going to lead no matter what. No matter what go on in this society, and no matter what the so-called white man doing, the leaders of the people is going to be the black men, so-called black men, and the so-called Hispanic men. They going to be the leaders. No matter if they some homos, you know, they on the wrong side of the track. It don't matter if they, it don't matter what they doing, man. They going to be the leaders because they are the leaders. You don't have a choice. If you're a man, you're a leader. You can be acting like you're not a leader, but you're still a leader. But he say, they all look to their own way, everyone for his gain, for his quarter. See, that was they people to tell you need to get tell your children not to listen to us. See, you need to tell your children and monitor your children. See, because I'm trying to get my money. I ain't worried about your children. I don't give a dang about your raggedy behind children. See, that's how they thinking. Because they worried about their game. They worried about their pockets. See, we broke around here. I ain't trying to sell dope. And I ain't trying to be a broke janitor. I ain't trying to be a broke worker on somebody's job. I want to get money. I want to live life and have money for my children. You see, they looking out for their own way and their own gain, and they can give a darn about the black, so-called black children and the so-called Hispanic children. See, but see, they don't want to give the truth to their peoples. They just want to tell a bunch of lies. Let's get Hosea 4 and 6. It say, my people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge, because thou have rejected knowledge. See, that's how they reject knowledge. And that's how these men, they reject the knowledge. Because your children going to understand. Your children going to hear what you got going on, man. Because you are the leader. They don't give a damn what their mama doing. They going to listen to what you got going on. And if it's a powerful situation, if you walking in truth and not in the path of some wicked idiot, they gonna see it. And they gonna understand it. Now, that's not even the whole thing. The Lord gonna reject your behind. See, that's another thing. See, you can do what you wanna do. All these Christians pushing this, all these Christian pastors pushing this Christianity. Read the Bible and try not to do wrong and all this crap. But they don't never do it. They be the worst peoples because the Lord ain't with them. The Lord know that you rejecting the true knowledge. You want to go with Christianity and the so-called white man. That's a false knowledge, and I'm going to reject you and your children. Your children are going to be the worst children on the block. They're going to follow these funky rappers and be the worst children, the monsters, oppressors. They're going to oppress your behind, murder you. A lot of these pastors' children, take them out. Take all their money, rob them. See, now when you look at these people, the Messiah, Yahawashah, who they ignorantly call Jesus Christ, sweet Jesus, with the name the so-called white man made pulled out of his behind. When you look at what he told us, what was going to be going on, man. Look at what he say, verse 11. Hit it right on the dot. He's saying, many false prophets shall rise and deceive many. See, these rappers are false prophets. The prophet not only telling you scriptures and talking about what's going to happen before it happens. They supposed to break down the scriptures to give understanding, and they are the leaders of the people. They always led. The king even listened to the prophets. The king hearkened to the words of the prophet, because they knew he was the word. They were the ones bringing the word of God, and God is the leader. So you got to listen to them to understand what God's saying, so you can lead the nation. King David was the king, and Samuel was the prophet. King David had to listen to Samuel and follow his direction, or he was going to have himself in trouble. Now, these wicked Negroes is leading the people, following the so-called greatest deceiver, because that's what it's all about, deception. That's why I say they shall deceive many, because they following Christianity and the so-called white man that be just running their mouth, ain't saying nothing at the end of the day, and they got these individuals, these wicked women, following they behind, because the club is just another church. Let me go, just get that in, 2 Timothy 3? Oh, 2 Timothy 4. In the last days. Talk about the last day. What's going to be happening in the last day? Look at this hymn. It say, but evil men and seducers shall wax worse and worse, deceiving and being deceived. See, that's what the rap music is all about, man. And I ain't even had that verse queued up and even thinking about that verse. But that's exactly what's going on with this rap music, man. But look, this is the club, because this was Rudy's nightclub. It say, for of this sort they are they which creep into houses through the radio, the television, and lead captive silly women laden with sins, led away with diverse lust. See, this is how they are led away, with this freaking rap music. These are the popular preachers. These have been the popular preachers since this music popped off in the 60s, the late 70s, because music wasn't even doing too much, but it started jumping off right when they when the Most High knocked off so-called Martin Luther the King. When he knocked them boys off, 1969, he brought the real truth and the real deal on the streets. And then he brought the strong delusion. Let me get that before I close out. The strong delusion he brought to these peoples because they wanted to believe the so-called white man and follow his funky behind. Now let's look at him. It says, I'm going to start at verse 9. It says, even him, the dragon, Esau, Edom, the devil, the so-called white man, whose coming is after the workings of Satan, the adversary, any adversary that was working against God, that's how he coming, with all power and signs and lying wonders. See, this is how that them songs and music is powerful. And it's a great sign to show you who is the target, who is God's peoples, and who is being targeted, because it's not targeting no other nation. Verse 10 is saying, with all deceivableness of unrighteousness in them that perish. See, they deceiving the peoples, thinking that unrighteousness is a good, great thing. Let's smoke, let's drink, let's get the pimp the girls, let's steal other men, women, let's kill a nigga. See, that's the stuff that these peoples are pushing, because they receive not the love of the truth that they might be saved. See, they not loving no. The prophet telling them, man, y'all the greatest peoples in the world. Y'all are the children of Israel. Y'all are God's chosen people. Every nation is against you and jealous of you and wants to kill you, wants to do away with you. But see, they want to believe a lie. That Christianity, God love everybody that's walking on the earth. Everybody is his children. He didn't have no plan. His only plan was to create Adam. And after Adam, everything was about everybody. See, forget God's plan that he wrote in the Bible. Forget his plan, what he wanted to do with his creation and how he wanted to organize it. Forget that crap. The white man say God love everybody and God gonna forgive everybody and he son of son to die for everybody. See, that's the ignorance that these Negroes wanna believe. But through the rap music, they push the same crap. They push heaven and hell, Christianity, wearing a cross, God love everybody. That's just another extreme church of Christianity, just extreme denomination. See, it say, for this cause, God shall send them strong delusion that they should believe a lie. See, you following the path, he told you not to follow the path of the wicked and of the evil men. See, the Israelite men, they are evil men to follow the path of the wicked, the so-called white man. You is the evil somebody because this man destroyed your people. Destroy your people, and you want to still follow this dragon. Let's get that. You want to follow the man that destroyed your people. You deserve to be destroyed, and this the strong delusion is set up just for you. If you want to follow the people that destroyed your people, I'm gonna set you on a path that's gonna destroy your behind. Psalm 83:4, they have said, the so-called white men, Look at verse 6, 9. You see all the nations that is talking about. All these nations have said, come and let us cut them off from being a nation, that the name of Israel may be no more in remembrance. See, that's what this thing is all about. These other nations, jealous of the chosen peoples. God want to pick out of all the people a priesthood like he did the Levites out of the 12 tribes. He picked Levi to be the priesthood. The other tribes didn't have nothing to say, and they can't be jealous of the situation because this is God's choice, and this is how he want to organize his creation. Now, when you go to, it was one more I wanted to hit them with. This is how he organized the situation. And they volunteering to destroy these people. I might want to end it on this one. Come and let us cut them off from being a nation, that the name of Israel may be in no more remembrance. See, the name of Israel is the whole key. And the blacks and the Spanish and Native Americans, that's why the Native Americans was almost slaughtered completely when these dragons came over here. But you got the so-called Mexican, Puerto Rican, Dominican Republics. These all from the Northern Kingdom. The Jamaicans, the Haitians, the other island, descendants of slaves, they come from Judah, Benjamin, and Levi. And Haitians are the Levites, the high priest. And so he want to organize this thing how he want to organize it, not how a raggedy red dragon so-called white man want to organize it, not no dusty Negro or crazy Hispanic want to organize the situation. He don't care about what y'all want to do. He gonna organize it how he want to organize it. I want one nation to be the leader and give the law to everybody. Let me get that. I want one nation to do it. I'm not with this everybody come together. I'm going to pick the best out of all nations. I don't want to pick the best out of all nations. I want to pick out of one nation. What did he say the people going to say in verse 3? He said, many people shall go and say, who are these people? These are other nations, man. It say all the nations shall flow into it. And that's what he's talking about. And many people shall say, he's talking about all the nations. Verse 3, it say, many people shall go and say, come ye, let us go to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob, and he will teach us of his ways. And we will walk in his ways. That's the ways of the law, the righteous law that Moses gave to the nation of Israel. For out of Zion meaning the people, not no freaking church, the people. These people is going to be giving out the law. For out of Zion shall go forth the law. He gave it to their forefathers, and that's what their purpose and was going to stay their purpose to the end of time. It say, and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. And this law came from the Lord. It was his word. And it's going to come from Jerusalem, his people. Jerusalem never, he don't give a, he liked that land. That's his special land where he going to set up his people and set up his order. But it wasn't about the land. It was about his plan. It was all about his plan. Plan, land, people. And so these people pushing Christianity. That's what these rappers is doing. And when you look at the 3-6 Mafia, them jokers, let me go back to my thumbnail. See, these Negroes was pushing pretty much demonic vibrations off the rip. They knew what they was pushing. The freaking Bone in 1999, they had the Ouija board on the back of their album. 3-6 Mafia already want to represent the devil with this 3-6-6. Because Christianity teach you the 3666 is some sign of the devil and all this crap, when it wasn't. It was just telling you this is what the white man going to use with his mark. This is a number he gonna push out there, and it's gonna be a sign to let you know who is the real devil. Because the one ain't no rebellious angel. See, ain't no rebellious angel that God say, okay, I'm gonna let you stay down there. You can't come up here, but you can stay down there on the earth and mislead all them people. See, that is not what the situation was. He told him and them spirits is sent to these wicked individuals. No matter what nation they from, if they being wicked, he got spirits that's created for vengeance to come against you and your wickedness. That's all that is. But these jokers been representing rebellion. It's all been about rebellion. Smoke, drink, kill, rebel against anything that's got to do with the Lord. And they with Christianity because Christianity teaches the same thing. The law is done away with. Rebel against any law that anybody come up to you and tell you, that crap is done away with, man. Don't worry about no law. That what you talking about, a law? Ain't no law. See? Same mess. Rebellion. And rebellion is the sin of witchcraft. And that's what these Negroes is helping the so-called white man push on the children and the people of our nation. Not knowing that they're the greatest peoples on the earth. And Deuteronomy 7 and 6 say we are special people above all people in the face of the earth. And these Negroes rejected. Because you ain't finna be pushing this crap. And you know what time we in. And you know what our peoples is finna get. The stuff that we finna get ain't nothing, no money that you Negroes can get that can compare to the kingdom that the Lord finna give to our nation. And you wanna sit up here and push this crap when everybody can see the so-called white man kingdom falling. He know it's falling. Every economic professional to tell you anything about economics, he can't help but to say, yeah, man, it's looking a hot damn mess. See, he can't even lie and say, oh, it's looking like that, but really, we're doing wonderful. See, he can't even tell that lie right now. So for a Negro to hear their people, the men of their nation, standing up telling them, the Lord only going to give us the understanding, man. You're not finna hear this from no other nation. You only going to hear it from us. We was in the projects together, the hood together, elementary school, high school. You only going to hear it from us. He only going to give us the understanding. We are his people, man. We ain't just great in music for no reason. We ain't got all these other nations following our music for no reason. Basketball, football, anything we do, they not following us just for circumstance. And because slavery made us hard or something, or did something to our psyche where we can do stuff better than everybody else. That's just retardation. It's because we his peoples and his spirit still on us, even though some of our men are wicked and want to follow the so-called devil. But I'm going to leave it there. Daniel chapter 7, verse 18. For the saints shall take the kingdom and possess the kingdom forever and ever and ever. See, that's how what the nation, the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, descendants of slaves, that's what they going to do. And it ain't nothing nobody going to be able to do about it. That's the plan of the Most High. And if you following these wicked Negroes, you're going to be destroyed. You despise the word. Oh, no, y'all, that's a white man book. And man, y'all waiting for y'all sky daddy to come out the sky. You're going to be destroyed, man. You spewing that ignorant mess, you're going to be destroyed. But I'm going to leave it there. All praise to Yahweh, Vashem, Yahweh Shah, Vashem, and Kakadash. Double honors to the elders, pushing the truth, peace to the elect. Worldwide, our kingdom is at hand. Shalom.